All right. First of all, just say your name for me and spell it. I'm Joe from Fox 59, by the way.
Hi, Joe. Nice to see you. Shaun Grannis, S-H-A-U-N, last name G-R-A-N-N-I-S.
And, just give us your title.
Sure. Vice President for Data and Analytics at the Regenstrief Institute.
Okay, so we're talking about the new Merck pill.
Yeah.
What can you tell me about it? What do you know about it right now?
Sure. So we know that in clinical trials, the pill has been shown to reduce hospitalizations and deaths from among people who have coronavirus. So that means that if you have coronavirus, once you have symptoms, ideally within 24 hours, you start taking this medication to help reduce your chances of hospitalization, even death, and it will likely also mitigate or reduce your symptomology as well.
Okay, and I just have a few questions from reporter Justin Kolar. The pill, if approved by the FDA, would drastically reduce the load that's been on hospitals since the pandemic began. What would this mean for the fight against the pandemic?
Sure, I think this is another tool in our toolkit to battle the pandemic. And so what I think this does mean is that for people who experience coronavirus-like symptoms, who are infected with COVID, this is another tool in the arsenal. And I certainly think for those people at risk for severe illness, those people who are elderly, have multiple comorbidities, this is another very powerful tool. This is not unlike we already have monoclonal antibody infusions that we would provide. So when a person gets COVID symptoms, they test positive, they can get an antibody infusion. Antibody infusions are, they take time, you've got to go to the hospital. They cost about $2,000 for that infusion. Right now, we know the federal government's paying about $700 for a dose of the new Merck pill. And I would just point out too that vaccinations are still one of the frontline approaches here. We would much rather prevent the illness from ever happening by getting vaccinated. If you happen to contract the illness, you have the pill, you have the infusion to minimize your symptoms. And this really is very much like Tamiflu. Many people have heard of Tamiflu for influenza. This is very similar to that. As with Tamiflu, within 24 hours, you're supposed to be taking that pill. So one of the things that we're going to have to think about with the new Merck pill, if it's approved by the FDA, is that people need to, as soon as they test, as soon as they have symptoms, they need to get tested, because ideally you're going to want to be on the pill within 24 hours. And that's going to take some pretty rapid turnaround in order to see that happen, to maximize the benefit of the pill.
And if we're comparing the Merck pill to the Tamiflu pills or the Tamiflu dosage, what is the dosage for the new Merck pill? How will this all work?
Yeah, so it's four pills twice a day for 5 days. You take a total of 40 pills for the Merck pill.
Okay. Would you foresee folks who have been on the fence about receiving an injection to fight the virus being more inclined to take a pill instead to help the population get closer to herd immunity?
Sure. So I guess I would answer that by saying, you know, vaccination is our number one defense against this. I'm very glad that we've got, in fact, I'm excited that there's the possibility for the Merck pill. And there's others, Pfizer and others, AstraZeneca are working on a pill as well. So we may be seeing a few of them coming out soon. But it is always better if you can prevent the disease than to get the disease. So $20 for a vaccine, $700 for the Merck pill, $2,000 for an infusion, an average of $20,000 for a COVID hospitalization. So if you just look at from an economic perspective, vaccines make a lot of sense, but the pill very much so is a welcomed addition to the COVID-19 arsenal.
Is there anything else you want to add that I haven't asked about this pill?
I think we've covered it. I think it'll unburden the infusion centers as well. I know that the level of COVID-19 in the community is decreasing, which is awesome. When the rates were elevated, you know, we were even seeing some delays and bottlenecks with getting people in for the monoclonal antibody infusion. So if we do see rates rise again, we now have multiple outpatient treatments for COVID-19. And I think that's good news.